if 意思是如果， if 结构用来判断某一条件是否达成，如果条件达成则进行指定的操作。 if which is used in conjunction with a comparison operator tests whether a certain condition has been reached, such as an input being above a certain number. 比如以下的例子，如果变量 sample 大于50，则大括号里的程序段被执行。如果 sample 小于或等于50，则大括号里的程序不被执行。The format for an if test is given on the screen. If the variable sample is greater than 50, the code in the curly brackets will be executed. If the sample is less or equal to 50, the code will not be executed. 也可以这么说，如果 if 语句括号里的比较操作结果为真值，大括号里的程序段将被执行，否则 if 结构完成，接着往下运行。Put another way, if the statement in the parentheses is true, the statements inside the brackets are run. If not, the program skips over the code. 如果大括号里只有一条指令，大括号也可以省略，变成The curly brackets may be omitted after an if statement if there is a so line statement. 在 if 后的括号里，通常有屏幕中所示的几种比较操作符。The comparison operators in an if statement include x 等于10 x is equal to 10 x 不等于10 x is not equal to 10 x 小于10 x is less than 10 x 大于10 x is greater than 10 x 小于或等于10 x is less than or equal to 10x 大于或等于10 x is greater than or equal to 10。
The first Noel the angel did say was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they
特别需要注意的是，双等号是一个比较操作符，单等号是赋值操作符，二者有本质的不同。如果需要用 if 结构比较两个数是否相等，则需要用双等号而不是单等号。比如 if sample 是否等于100，如果误写成 sample 等于100，则是把数值100赋值给变量 sample， 并不是比较 sample 与100的相等关系。Beware of accidentally using the single equal sign. The single equal sign is the assignment operator and sets sample to 100, puts the value 100 into the variable sample. Instead, use the double equal sign.Which is the comparison operator, and tests whether sample is equal to 100 or not. The latter statement is only true if sample equals to 100, but the former statement will always be true. 一个 if 结构可以对一个条件进行判断，如果加上 else 结构，则可对多个条件进行依次判断。比如以下的例子，在这个 if else 结构中，由 if 判断变量 sample 是否大于100，如果大于100，则进行赋值操作，结果 x 等于10，如果 sample 不大于100， 也就是小于或者等于100，则进行另一个赋值操作，结果 x 等于0。If else allows greater control over the flow of code than the basic if statement, by allowing multiple tests to be grouped together. For example, the variable sample can be tested and one action taken if the sample was greater than 100, and another action taken if the sample was 100 or less. In this example, else can precede another if test, so that multiple mutually exclusive tests can be run at the same time. 另外，还可用 else if 结构对不同的条件进行逐一判断。这样，如果 sample 大于100，则 x 赋值10；如果 sample 小于100，则 x 赋值50。其余的条件下，比如 sample 等于100，则 x 赋值0。在 if else 结构中，是实际需要可以使用 else 结构来结束，也可以不使用 else 来结束。Else if is another statement used for testing conditions. Once an else if succeeds, none of the remaining else if or else statements will be tested. Note that an else if block may be used with or without a terminating else block and vice versa. An unlimited number of such else if branches is allowed. In this example, if sample is greater than 100, x is assigned by 10. Else if sample is less than 100, x is assigned by 50. Otherwise, x is assigned by 0.有几点需要注意，程序中可以使用一个或多个 if. Keep in mind, there can be one or multiple ifs in the sketch. 在 if 后可以没有 else 或只能有一个 else. Else 必须放在 else if 之后。An if can have zero or one else statement, and it must come after any else ifs.在 if 之后可以没有 else if 或者多个 else if， 所有 else if 必须在 else 之前。 An if can have a zero to many else if statements, and they must come before the else.